It's crazy what we put ourselves through just chasing a duck. So why do we do it? Because we have to. It's in our blood. It's in our DNA.
It's something I can't explain, a feeling it puts in you, and it's, why do they do that? 3:30 in the morning, got icicles hanging off their eyebrows, mud in their ears, mud in under their fingernails. Why? Because a man above just put it in us.
You know, being a guide, you get a really cool taste of life. As a kid, you know, everybody goes to high school, then they go to college, and then you get student loans, you get your degree for a job that you don't like. Next thing you know, you're in a house you can't afford. And all of a sudden, they wake up one day, they're 50, 60 years old, and like, where'd my life go? And so, you know, we're gonna be right here, doing what we love.
Until you get that feeling in that ticker when it beats like that right there and gets faster and faster and faster, and the hair stands up on your arm, the back of your neck, it's a dream. The fuel it puts in you, it lights you fire. That's the life.
They was a little bit out there, I'd say, but he's riding home with us. Not far enough. I was fixing to say the good Lord is actually telling us we need to shoot some of his teal because we're getting greedy. And then those two fellas dropped in there. Fat bag mallets. You know, it used to not be a fad or a phase or a popular thing, but nowadays you can find people duck hunting just about anywhere. If you ask me, it all starts and ends right here.
He'll come back around, just stay squatted down. Get ready, guys, right in front. Get ready. Shoot him, shoot him, kill him.
One of the best keys to success is being on the X. And here at Honey Break, we're on the X. We're 13 miles from Catahoula Lake. We are 14 miles from Mississippi River. It's open water, it's flooded timber, it's moist soil management, it's agricultural land. You know, all these things are a hotbed for the progression of the sport. I'm here working for you, late into the night. I mean, it's a grind working 300 days a year to get ready for that opening day. Like I said, it's a lot of work, and you can't do it all on your own. You're gonna need some friends.
Next time you sit in this blind right here, and you reach out there and scan across it, won't look like the same place. There's about 600 acres of water, hopefully full of green heads, teal. Be on, trying to make the sky. What's the most important to you on a duck hunt? To me, it's the retriever. A well-trained retriever, a machine. One that can go get it at 800 yards or 8 yards. When he says it can't be got, just hold up. We'll see.
It's something about watching a dog. I mean, a good dog can make a bad hunt a great hunt, and a bad dog can make a great hunt a bad hunt.
People come here, clients come here to get the best duck hunting experience that they can get. We got a day or 3 days to give it to them. Without the dog, I don't think you could give it to them.
they're the greatest conservation tool that we use every day. I mean, if you ask Jared, he can tell you who it was kin to and what bloodline it is, this, that, and the other. And he'll get so fired up about it, he'll start being a little bobblehead talking about it.
First of all, you couldn't get out here without a dog because you'd be so sore and tired, you couldn't walk no more. After you pick up about 1,000 of them and walk, and I've had it happen. I've had guides come and say, I don't need a dog. I'll walk and get them. And I laugh at them and say, I'll ask you that same question in 5 days.
I would have to say the number one reason I do this is it's got to be the clients.
Pretty self-explanatory. Right out front is directly where you're looking. We may have to shoot some of them straight up. When we do that, I'll let you know, they're coming over the back, coming off my end, your end, and we'll just shoot them right in the belly when they float over.
And with that being said, it puts a lot of pressure on me.
They're going to spend all that money and travel all the way down here. I mean, if you think about it, time's the most valuable thing in the world. We can't get it back, we can't buy it back. So I really like to make sure that they're spending their time wisely when they're with me.
So most guides, they all start out because they love to hunt or love to fish, whatever they're doing. You're basically supporting your habit. It starts, morphing into, in some cases, in my case specifically, into a career.
So I was watching those three and all of a sudden three more came in. Yeah, those three went that way. I was like, man.
If you're good at it, you'll learn early enough to develop a servant's heart. It's about giving back and not about you. And so that's what separates the good guides from the weekend warriors, is what I think.
But it's just no feeling in the world like that when them ducks come in there and get right and get tight, and then you look over there and there's 6 men, 8 men, 10 men, however, and every one of them's got a smile from ear to ear. That's life.
You also gotta try to have a good attitude when you come to the blind every day. You want to create a good environment for everybody to be in, a safe one, send them home with a good experience. Of course, we want to come out here and kill them just as much as they do. You're going to have bad days, you're going to have good days, and you're going to have days in between. Just accept all of them and enjoy the good ones and make the best of the bad ones. I'm just blessed and fortunate that I've got this opportunity to do what I do.
Well, clients are a very important part of the job. I mean, we wouldn't be here technically if it wasn't for clients, but one thing about it is it's like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're going to get.
You're going to get one that's never touched a shotgun. You're going to get one that's killed everything. You're going to get one that knows every duck that comes through there, but they're usually wrong. Fourth group of birds come in. Gray duck, teal. I said, well, that was ring next, the first group that come through.
Killing.
The second group that come through was gadwalls, you call mallards.
Kill them. Hey, get out of here.
The third group to come through was gray ducks you call pintails.
Kill them.
And then the last group was ringnecks when you thought they were teeth.
We take all kinds. We take guys that we've pulled their tags off their clothes and put their shotguns together.
Tim, this is how y'all shoot. Just like that.
And then you got your all-time favorites. Every time I even hear a duck, or you say right here, the pie facers.
If you want to kill big ducks and kill big ducks, here's a picture of what you looked like yesterday, sitting in that blind. What a bunch of them look like.
That's a good-looking crew.
Yeah, and every duck seen them. That's what you look like if you duck hunt. Do you see anybody? There ain't none of them paying a bit damn attention back there.
That's the icing on the cake. That's the reward that we get. It's they're getting out of the hole and then you hit it and they tip those wings and you know you changed their mind. You've tricked them. And that's making the hair on the back of my neck stand up right now.
Why are you so worried about a duck? Why do you want to get out there and get wet and cold every day for just a duck? Now honestly, I don't really know.
So why do we do this? To me personally, it's the ducks.
It's the duck. It did something to me as a kid that just made me try to figure them out.
I I'm exhausted and I can still get up tomorrow and go, and the next day, and the next day.
But there's a lot of people out there that just, it's hard to explain what it does to them, how it gets in their blood, how it gets in their head, how it gets in their mind. I've changed things all the way up in my life because in the name of the duck.
From what I've heard, it must be similar to doing drugs. They can't quit doing drugs, and I can't quit shooting ducks. I don't know what it is.
I'm as hungry to watch another one fall here in a minute as I was when I shot my first one at 5. I'm hungry, I love it, I eat it, I sleep it, I breathe it. Most people think they like it, but when they come stay with me for about 360 days, they decide they really didn't love it. They thought they did.
When you finish them, when you've tricked them, when you've won that chess match.
And it gets sideways and turns and goes to coming down like that and sticks its slippers out.
And that powder burns and you can smell it. And you're looking down the blind there, high-fiving, and they're all giddy.
So they get there and they get right and they swing around us. We hit them again with the right call. And he goes, oh, I got to get in there. Oh, I just need to bring him just 10 more foot and you just get faster. Hit him whatever you're going to hit him with. And then when you look over and say, and they're about to break out the blind because they can't hold back no more, everybody, then you say, now kill him. Get you some, boys.